everyone. Today we're here at Mama Lou's Dumpling House in Monterey Park, which is basically kind of a Chinatown in itself. And we're here trying out Chinese cuisine at one of the local restaurants. A very famous local one. It took a long time to get in here actually because of the line. But I think it's worth it because as you can see here, we've got an assortment of Chinese cuisine. We've got these steamed buns that have been slightly fried, and we've got the sauce that accompanies it. And then we've got this spicy slash sweet soup that has tofu and
green onion.
A bunch of other good stuff in here. And then we also have
kung pao
chicken, you know, just kung pao chicken, right? Chicken, vegetables, etc. And then we've got fried rice. You can see there's some shrimp in there, some beef, peas, eggs, etc. And then we've got which is like tofu, veggies, the green stuff, and some shrimp in there. And finally, last but not least, we have the beef soup with noodles. There's noodles, beef soup, and some
cabbage.
Okay, since obviously most of you probably haven't eaten these before. So we're gonna start with these. These fried buns. So how you eat them is you know, dip them in. Now the taste of these are pretty sweet because the sauce is like some kind of milk cream. So it's sweet, but it's not overly sweet like sugar. And the bun balances out because the bun itself is kind of plain. And then for these. Pretty spicy, so if you're not good at spicy foods, you might not want to try this, but if you can handle spicy, I would definitely recommend this because it's really good, it's really sweet, if you can get past the spiciness, and it's got a lot of flavor, and it heats you up on a cold day, so if it's really cold, you know, take one of these. Next, we'll try this. This is kind of like the opposite of that. This is more plain, more bland, kind of. But it's also very good because you get the tofu, you get the shrimp, you get these plain flavors. They just come together. And overall, it's just very good, very nutritious as well. More nutritious than this. So if you don't like exciting, you can choose this if you like more average. And then we'll try a little bit of the kung pao chicken. Now, I'm sure all of you have tasted kung pao chicken at one time or another, so you know what it's supposed to taste like. And so I'll take a chunk bite. And this is good. It's not spicy. But you can taste the chicken. The sauce is not overbearing. You get a good amount of onions, nuts, etc. You get all that combination of flavors. So I'd recommend this dish too. Rice comes next. So like I mentioned before, there's a lot of stuff in the rice. There's like beef and shrimp. It's good, it's not overcooked, it's not undercooked either. It's just the right amount. The blend is just right too, there's not too much beef, not too much shrimp. This all comes together kind of, and the egg as well. So overall, would say this is a pretty good rice. Like, you know, typical of what you'd expect from a Chinese restaurant.
Okay.
Last but not least, we got the Niro Mia, or the beef noodle. These noodles are kind of long and very hard to handle with a spoon or using chopsticks and stuff. And let me get a little bit of this. So, the noodles. Sometimes when you go to a Chinese restaurant, you know, like one of those bad ones, the noodles will be undercooked and it tastes really not pleasant. But these are great. These are definitely an alternative to the rice. So the way it works is the rice is like the main dish, and then you've got a couple of these side dishes. And you can choose between rice, noodles, or the buns. And I'd say overall all three of these dishes are good main dishes. But if I had to choose one out of the three, I'd choose this. The rice, because I like that the most out of all of them. And then, out of the three side dishes, I choose this the most because I like spicy soup that's also really sweet or really tangy. Girl. And before I forget, there's one more dish that we ordered, it just came out. So, these are pork dumplings. They're actually a specialty of this restaurant, so I'm eager to try out this dish. The way it works is they're basically steamed. And let's just get one and open it up and see what it tastes like.
Okay.
This is what it looks like. Inside is pretty juicy, as you can see. There's a lot of soup inside, believe it or not. And that tastes really good. The meat is really soft, so you can chew into it really easily. And taste is phenomenal. And it's just the right temperature, too. It's not too hot, it's not too cold. So actually, I think this is the best dish out of all the dishes that we sampled today. And these dishes, they don't take long to prepare, only like 10 minutes for a couple. And they're each about $6 to $7, so not too expensive. I think they're very reasonable for their price range. And so if I had to be asked, is this worth the price? I would say definitely yes. I would definitely recommend this restaurant. If you ever get a chance to come out to Monterey Park, you should definitely come to Mama Lou's Dumpling House in Monterey Park at 153 East Garvey Avenue. And that's it. So I'll see you guys next time. Stay updated on our social media. And we'll come back with another video sometime in the near future. Thanks for watching.